I have lost a lot of friendships because of my love for being alone so much. And it's really, really difficult for people to get me out to go do things. Which is one of the reasons why I used to use substances so much, is I found that when I was snorting opiates or super drunk, that I became this person that I wanted to be, which was this very outgoing, social, funny guy. And I wish in those times I could drink casually like a normal person, so that I could semi fit in and become that person that I liked being when I was on substances early on. David and I's relationship is interesting because we're in two different stages of life. 7 or 8 years older than I am. He's married, he's got a house. Sometimes I look up to him like he's a big brother, because it seems like he's done a lot of shit right in his life. And I look up and go, man, how do you do that? Like, I really want that.
I do tend to devalue my experiences sometimes because I think I'm normal. It's probably one of the things I probably struggle the most with, is wanting to feel valued and wanting to feel approved. And I approach things very competitively, and I want the words that come out of my mouth to hold weight. And in my head, even coming into this, I wanted to, like, if I'm honest, I wanted my story to be as good as Matthew's story. After you write a good song, there's a distinct feeling I have that's like this terror. That's like, what if I'll never be able to do this again? It's this fear of like, what if they see me for who I really am? And it's a problem. But that cycle, that life journey, is why we create art. And that's the challenge, is to constantly move your art forward and tell different stories, because we keep feeling.
I think the reason why I went to drugs and alcohol in the first place was because I was so afraid to share my struggles. And so music became my way of writing in a diary. You have to do something so you're not constantly wrestling inside of your mind, just telling you to do stuff. Which is why it's so important for me to let people know that, like, I'm not doing music to try and make money or get fame or power, because I genuinely don't give a shit about that stuff. It's just an opportunity for me to go, this is how I feel today, I gotta get it out.
Matthew and I have talked about this from early days. Our hope is that by us being vulnerable and sharing our stories and sharing our insecurities, other people will realize that that's the way. Let's not give off this fake perception that we're all together and we have it together. Let's talk about real life, the other 99% of our life that isn't roses.
Alcohol especially is something I still struggle with. Like, I can go 6 months without, and then there's one night where I just get fucked up. And I go to him the next day and I go, man, I don't know what happened. I just wanted to get out of my reality for a little bit. And he's like, you know what, man? We move on. And it takes an incredible amount of trust for me, especially, to open up to somebody. And I think that's why Miss You has worked so well, is because outside of music, outside of creating, there is that like brotherly bond of going, hey man, I literally trust you with my life, and you've watched me grow as a human in the past 3-4 years. Like, that's what helps Miss You and the vision of what we're trying to accomplish with speaking to other people about this subject matter.